The time has finally come. We are now entering the Renaissance.
Beyonce has just released her 7th studio album. Wow, 7. This is Beyonce's 7th studio album, and it is called Renaissance. The world is on fire right yes. now.
I'm so fucking excited.
You have every reason to be.
It's so nostalgic, but it also feels so new because she hasn't done an album rollout in a really long time. So to have this rollout, it just brings back feelings that, I don't know, it's something that we were missing in music and album releases. Because again, Beyonce said they're not making albums anymore, but she's gonna continue to do that.
I think what was missing was the anticipation. Yeah. You know, like, she announced this, what, a month in advance?
Yeah, and just about.
We're not used to waiting that long anymore.
No,
so,
yeah.
So, while this was a pretty long wait, I didn't feel it, you know? Yeah. And there wasn't much to go off of. We never got a Break My Soul music video.
No, we didn't.
There was never another single. You know, personally loved was the promotion of the album as a body of work. Meaning the vinyl cover reveal.
Yes.
The poses reveal.
Yeah.
You know, the little videos of the booklet or, you know,
things like that
were promoting the album, like I said, as a whole. It really helps you focus on the fact that this is a project. I think we all can come to the agreement that this might be Beyonce's best album cover, which is wild considering she's on her 7th.
I'm gonna have to agree, this album cover is amazing, even the vinyl cover. Listen, we bought the limited edition vinyl cover, but let me also see this vinyl cover in the store.
Yeah.
And I will be buying 3 copies. I'm mad that we didn't get a box.
When it comes to releasing an album, sometimes there are bumps along the way.
There are.
The album did leak, and somehow, I don't know how, somehow over there in France, y'all had the album in your grasp. And while I am jealous, it is unfortunate. However, Beyonce did post a message to everyone, thanking those that waited, because it does mean a lot to an artist. You know, you don't work that long on a body of work and have a set release date just for it to get leaked early and everyone kind of ruin the experience.
Yeah.
So, you know, I felt bad, but we're gonna dance through it. It's here.
From what I've seen on Twitter, because of course it's trending, people, they're saying it's so different for Beyonce, but it feels so good. And again, that was the purpose of the album while she created it in the pandemic, or during the pandemic, was to have a safe place, a place of, you know, no judgment, and to feel safe and a sense of freedom. So I'm really interested to see how that is portrayed within the music, because this, I could just tell Beyonce has never ever done something like this, and this is gonna be our first time hearing it, and that's what makes me so excited. So I'm ready for these 16 songs.
Not only are we stepping into a renaissance, but it definitely feels like Beyonce is is stepping into a new chapter within her own artistry, which is hard to do this far in the game, but
she's doing
she's
it.
She's Beyonce.
I pull up in these clothes, look so good. Cause I'm on that hoe.
Hey. What is happening?
It's not the time.
Ooh.
It's not the time. I'm that girl.
These soft vocals on this beat. I am going to hit something.
It's not my name.
She said.
Wow.
It's not Jay. It's B. It's me.
I hate talented black people. Her vocals on this beat is like a I can't describe what the beat is doing. Yeah. But her voice, I did not think I'm That Girl was gonna sound like
me
that
either.
At all.
Like it's building up to something. Is this gonna be an album that flows?
That just flows completely.
I love that. That was
Yeah, that was a good opener.
Yeah, Beyonce hasn't made an album like this. This is gonna be something new.
Yeah. This is gonna be something new. Just off that, I can tell that this is gonna be something experimental, fresh, and new for Beyonce.
Yes, it's right. This is a
This is a reinvention. It's a renaissance.
How do you reinvent yourself three times?
It's called talent.
That chorus is so freaking catchy. And the thing that sucks is that it only happens one time.
One time. The way that the song is structured, it feels like such an intro.
It's such a good intro.
It feels cocky. It feels honest. It feels a little dark. It feels a little mysterious.
Yes.
Like, I don't know what we're getting into
Me
here,
either.
But I like it.
When I tell you, I don't think I've been this excited for an album in a minute.
She about to fuck us up.
Just a reminder.
Go.
Yeah. That flow.
Okay. Okay. I love that line. That's a line.
Yeah.
Her children. Yeah. Don't.
Yeah.
Don't.
Yeah. Not just the children, but just like, you know how they say what you've been through?
No, everything.
It made you who you
are. But to think that that's that and so also her children.
Yeah.
Wow. Beyonce just knows Carter.
But I love how this is kind of like her speaking to the public a little bit, because I love the burning of the dagger from the words that you say.
Yeah.
Dancing in the mirror, kiss my scars, I guess, from the dagger, because I love what they made.
Exactly.
So y'all were so hard on me.
It
y'all
made
had
a
so
stronger
much to
person.
Say. It made me stronger.
Yeah. Wow.
She comfortable. Is that? Of course, sometimes shit go down when there's $1 billion on the elevator.
Oh my god, I love that.
Has Beyonce ever said the word pussy?
I don't think Beyonce's ever said pussy.
Not Pink Panther.
I love her flow. I love this.
Crazy.
It's gonna keep flowing into these fucking songs.
And you know what? I think the purpose of that is because this album is supposed to be an experience. And
oh my god,
it's not supposed to be mixing with other tracks at the club.
It's not singles.
When you go to the club, just play Renaissance.
That's
just
it. Play the whole damn album.
Just played all night.
I love Cozy.
Cozy was not what I expected.
It's not what I expected. But I feel like that's going to be repeating thing on this album. It's not going to be what I expect.
Yeah, the album isn't what I expect. I feel like what she's doing is...
Obviously,
she's not singing yet. And I don't know if we're going to get that on this album.
But the thing is, we've gotten it. So she doesn't need to do it.
But I think that's part of the reinvention.
It's more fun vocally. It's more fun lyrically. But that production
is
what the time was.
It's complementing each other. So,
yes.
So it doesn't sound cheap and it doesn't sound lazy.
Exactly. Because imagine it could. Kind of lyrics as fun, not simple, not bad, fun as they are.
Yeah.
Over simple as
and
beats
straightforward.
Would sound very underwhelming.
Yes, but the way that it's being structured is what's helping.
But then even to a certain point, the lyrics, they're just so
light.
They're
like
so
that first verse.
That first verse was amazing.
That first verse is amazing.
We're two songs in, but I'm fucking loving it.
And Beyonce cussing.
Pussy Pink.
Please do not be alarmed. Remain
calm. Hell yeah, I know that sounds good as fuck.
Do not attempt to leave the dance floor. The DJ booth is conducting a troubleshoot test.
I love it.
I'm one of one. I'm number one. I'm the only one.
It's that funk disco. Like, she's playing so into that to where she's like, listen, I don't have
this
to
reminds
melt.
Me of
y'all know that I can sing.
This reminds
now let's just have some fun. And that's what I know she was after. Because this album took over a year to work on.
Yeah.
But during the pandemic, but it was about letting loose. It
exactly,
was about exploring
exactly.
and being even more creative. So it makes sense that Beyoncé is exploring a part of, you know, her talent
that
and her voice that she hasn't done in a full body of work before.
Exactly.
I feel like we've heard hints of this throughout her discography.
But not a full,
but not a full body
a
of work.
A full-length album.
Don't even waste your time trying to compete with me. Keep him addicted. Lies on his lips. I lick it.
I love that. Unique again. That's right.
That's what you are. Category. Bad bitch. I'm the boss.
This, you know what? Okay, wait, you know what I noticed? And I have to say this. I was reading on who this album is dedicated to, and it's
yes.
dedicated to her uncle,
yes.
who happened to be gay,
yep.
and I believe passed
from HIV.
HIV.
Yeah.
So this, the minute you say category, I can only think of...
Yep, ball.
That,
ball
yeah.
room. Too classy for this world.
On that girl. Diamonds and pearls.
Put on eyes on you when you perform. Eyes on I when I put on. Mastermind and haute couture. Label horse can't clack. I'm so obscure.
Yes, this is
it. Can you see pleasure in my glare? Look over my shoulder and you ain't scared.
Oh,
that
oh.
you have on me when you...
Yes, you heard the harmony.
Oh my god, that's amazing. But like, recapping still, I'm that girl Cozy. Yeah.
Diamonds beneath my eyes, where his ego will find bliss. Music when you speak, you're so unique.
That was dope.
Wow.
Unique. Sexy bitch, I'm the boss.
Bitch.
Alien superstar. We dress a certain way, we walk a certain way. But these things we do in a different, unique, specific way that is personally ours.
Oh, I love that.
Wow.
Superstar, supernova.
Yeah.
Fuck, I love that.
That's nice. She might as well just call that one unique. Because that's what
but
that
you know
one was.
What? I love these titles so far. They're
Same.
So different.
They are. Alien Superstar.
And I love how they're just dropped. That reminded me of a galaxy out of this world.
Yeah.
I love that one.
I think a lot of us were claiming track 3. Definitely did not disappoint.
That was actually one of my...
I think, yeah.
Pre-album, like, you know how you next, claim a song?
Yeah.
It was Alien Superstar, Plastic Off the Sofa, and America Has a Problem.
Yeah, I think that I'm going to walk away with that one being still one of my favorites.
Wow.
I love the ending. We just reaching out to the solar system. So,
yeah.
Basically, you're just out of this world. You're original.
Yes.
You know, an alien... superstar. It just gives that energy.
Which
so.
Then bounces off of Cozy, but then also
yeah,
I'm That Girl.
It does. And
so,
y'all know we love an album with the sequencing.
With the good sequencing. I'm personally speechless because this is so different and I love different.
I almost want to do something different.
What's that?
And like, not even stop and talk.
I know. I think I want to listen to the whole thing straight through.
Yeah.
That's the experience. That's what I feel with the experience.
Like, I'm like, the way that it's flowing.
This shit's crazy.
It's just a vibe. I think we need to just listen to this all the way through.
I feel like falling in love. I'm going to fuck something up. Better fucking something.
This reminds me a little bit of Blow.
I'm gonna go missing. I need a prescription. Can I sit on top of you? I wanna go with nobody's been.
Spaceships alien. Right. I like that. I can't even mimic that. My god.
Okay, this is giving me classic Beyoncé though.
This shit's good.
I'm getting yeah.
This shit's good.
It's just good shit.
I love, I'm sorry.
The elevation.
I love, no, the theming of space and aliens
going into this one,
hypersonic sex erotic.
Like, because this
what's up with that?
This music takes you to a different place, though. And that's what I'm saying. She's building an experience through, you know, sonically and lyrically. It's creating something for you that... that's very immersive.
Yes,
it's, and that's what I'm loving so
far.
That's
the word. It's immersive.
That's what I'm loving.
Oh my god, I love this.
Come on, rap Beyonce. There we go. This is sex in the club.
It took a Latin feel.
That's the way to move. La 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 la.
Cause them Karens just turned into terrorists.
She got you white bitches. No, we gotta talk about it. DJs don't even have to do shit. You don't even have to mix it. It's mixed for
it's
you.
Mixed, it's literally just fucking mixed for you, bro. Play the album.
That was epic.
Oh, the minute you heard the minute you point out
that
the
yeah,
I knew that was gonna. Oh my god, that sounded amazing.
That was epic.
My soul. I love.
Okay.
I love that.
Cuff It was amazing.
Cuff It was amazing.
I think that that's going to end up being one of my favorite songs.
I have to agree with
the
you.
The sexual energy.
I have
it was
to agree
a vibe.
With you.
Y'all, I really think we're about to listen to this project. So, I don't know how much more talking I can do.
No,
I just
literally, I want to be immersed in this. Like, let me speak our energy really quick, though.
Yeah.
Cuff It was amazing, and I do feel like it's going to be within my top three.
Same.
Energy was a great break, and I don't feel like Beyonce does a lot of interludes.
She doesn't.
It's rare.
But what's iconic is not labeling it as an interlude.
Exactly.
Because it was such a bridge between...
It's such a bridge between Cuff It and Break My Soul.
You make me upset. Like, I know that we've seen it before. I know that other artists are good at this very same craft.
However,
it's just something
they just
about
aren't
Beyonce.
Doing it like her. And I'm gonna leave it there.
That made me happy. I have to just say, the way that energy fits in is because right now it is all about
the energy.
And to go into Break My Soul, which is all about free energy.
Yes, yes.
Just genius.
Yes. You won't break my soul, I'm telling everybody. I just failed, I just quit my job.
Release the stress, release the love, forget the rest. I'm gonna tell my head. The knees in the front and the doms in the back. They're taking no flicks, but the whole click snap. Try to smoke with the yak in your mouth. And we back outside. You won't see it that we all know. Can't break my soul. You don't think it, you won't be it. We go round and circle, searching for love.
Paul Choir.
Wait, how's it gonna work in? Feel like we're walking. First song to not flow, and I'm excited. I feel like we've just entered a new phase in the album.
Yeah, and people have been very interested.
I'm interested in this
about one. Church Girl.
Church Girl was one of my
claimed songs?
Tracks.
Interesting.
Oh, I'm scared.
Well, we all know that we like Break My Soul. We gotta be
honest. We all know that.
So, to be honest, I don't have much to say about Break My Soul, except for it is an amazing leeway into this new feeling.
Yeah.
For the album.
Right,
so
in the
I'm
middle of it.
Very, very curious.
Not in the middle of it, but more like a transition.
More like a transition.
Okay, so Church Girl, did not expect that.
I didn't either.
A bounce track. That was actually, I think, perfectly timed within the album.
Yeah.
I don't know that it's one that I'm going to go back to
much.
Yeah,
I don't think I'm going to go back to it too much.
But I think that it was...
But
once
it's
again,
not what I thought.
It wasn't, but it was once again that free energy to
yes.
put the flip on the church girls
Girl.
Acting loose.
Yeah.
And the bad girls acting snotty. It was like, that's what this music brings out of you, you know? So once
yeah.
again, talking about the unexpected
yes.
and playing
yes.
off that, and Renaissance.
I like that flip.
The idea of change.
Yes.
That's embracing yeah. it.
Literally.
Forget the rest on Break My Soul.
Yeah.
So just like telling you to
yeah.
basically drop all of your responsibilities, the
just,
labels.
Just
drop everything
any
that
kind
holds
of
you
hesitation.
Down.
Yeah.
yeah. Anything that weighs you down, drop it. And sometimes
yeah.
being a church girl, maybe, or someone.
You have that stigma. You have that pressure.
Absolutely. And drop that.
Drop it.
Boy, I know you can't help but to be yourself around me. Yourself around me. It's the way you wear your emotions on both of your sleeves.
Wow. That run was beautiful.
Taking this title plastic off the sofa
I think
is
it's
Get Comfortable.
Get Comfortable.
And
yes.
take off that layer.
Literally, when the song was done, I was going to bring that up.
Yeah.
I love this so far is my favorite topic and title.
Mm-hmm.
Get Comfortable.
Hey! Boy, I love that
love
you
that.
Can't help but be yourself around me. When you're tripping, I know we'll make up and make love, so I let you be. It's the way you want one more kiss after you set you free. I like it, I love it, baby.
Ooh.
I love
was that?
that.
I don't know, but it was fucking genius.
Baby. Come on, Jordan, feel it?
No, no, no. I have to hear it. I have to hear it. Jordan. That was good.
Let's talk about it. So, Virgo's Groove is probably the song I was most excited for.
I was so interested because it's so long.
It's 6 minutes. The title is intriguing.
Yeah.
And Virgo, stemming from, obviously, her zodiac sign.
Yeah.
Just, I knew this was going to be a smash. I think that might be... It's right up there with Alien Superstar for sure. Not sure which one is my favorite.
Alien Superstar or Cuff It.
Alien Superstar and Cuff It, to be honest
with you. Yeah.
But even though I really loved Energy.
I think Virgo's Groove is my favorite.
I was going to say that you could feel the groove coming in.
Hell yeah.
Toward the end of Plastic Off the Sofa. That's why I was like, let it go. Because
during the minute the beat started to pick up and immediately went into Virgo's Groove, I'm sorry, I couldn't stop it.
You couldn't stop it because that's the point. I think it was geniusly put together because, like I was saying, it was... finding a new way to reintroduce that same beat to you over and over, whether it was through a vocal or through an added instrument. So
yes.
That was just smart and just...
It
was groovy. I love that.
Like, and even Plastic Off the Sofa, I think that's going to be one of my favorites. That was so different. And yeah, right. I didn't think it was going to be a slow song, but I loved... The play on Plastic Off the Sofa and getting comfortable in that vulnerability. Oh my god, I'm loving the topics that we're touching on.
And this song's just about confessing your love to somebody.
Oh hell yeah.
This
to me makes me want to grab somebody and dance with them.
Yeah.
And just feel the emotions and let our bodies do the talking. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
I love
music
that.
Music is such a language.
And she knows how to speak it.
Very well. She's fluent. Okay, but we got Grace Jones on this one.
Right. Move out the way. When the queen comes to like the rest say, move out the way.
Oh. How many times I'ma say, fuck up, bitch, fuck up, bitch, fuck up. Humble like me, probably come up. Don't make it turn into trouble. What? Watch my reflection on my face. I don't need to call him. I don't need no phone. Always flow.
Wow.
See how the like talking in the back is continuous from move into this?
Yes.
To where it sounds, it complements the other.
Oh, hell
that,
yeah.
That's what I mean about keeping that continuity, I guess.
Yes, also yes, just, yes, yes.
It's like one thread that doesn't stop.
Exactly.
There's little turns here and there, but it doesn't
stop. But it doesn't stop.
I love that.
But to be honest, that's been since the first song.
Yes. Move was a very fun one. I think that one is one that you want to.
Yeah, and I love how Grace wasn't, or Thames, was, they weren't main, like, verses and everything. They were just key components.
They're there to help the experience.
Exactly, exactly.
And who better to hear from than Grace Jones?
And Grace Jones.
The influence that I'm hearing. Wow.
Yeah. That last part is probably my favorite part of the song.
Heated went off low key.
This that one was last just, part.
The attitude, the topic.
The topics.
It was just hot all around.
Yeah.
Heated. This is like.
That's so crazy to think that that's the 11th track and it doesn't
feel like it.
I think because it's they flowing. Flow,
yeah.
You just get lost in it.
It feels like we're somewhere maybe on 8 or 9.
That's what I'm saying. Like, it doesn't feel like I'm more than halfway done with the album. That last part of Heated, that's my favorite.
It went off.
That shit, I just stopped and say, is that really fucking Beyonce?
No, yeah, like, it was.
What the hell?
But once again, bringing those influences of, and mentioning Uncle Johnny again, when those, yeah. I feel like we know, like, those songs, when they mirror, I guess you could say ballroom, that ballroom culture. When the songs mirror that underground scene, I love it. When she brings that element in, it's showing an appreciation for the sounds not heard.
Exactly.
And that's what's going to make this album so special, I think.
Yes.
Because for people that have never been introduced to that world or been around or heard those underground scenes, to them it's going to sound brand new.
Right.
But that's how you kind of bring something to the forefront.
Hell yeah.
And it gets the recognition that it deserves. Because a lot of those underground scenes, artists paved the way. And we don't even know it. For the sounds that we have today.
No, it's the truth.
I think Heated was definitely one of those songs that will stand out on the album.
Yeah, I have to agree with you.
Desk getting bigger. Cash getting larger. He thought he was loving me good. I told him go harder. That's that dick, that's that real shit. That's that jelly, baby. Champagne and cherry, baby. That's that dick, that's that na-na. That oochie, oochie, la-la. Hit it in the car and take you back to the casa. I got you rock now. Eat that shit like Nostros. She say she on the diet, girl. You better not over that ass. That's that dick, that's that real shit.
I like this. Ooh. You know what she could have done with this? She could have done a real nasty beat drop where it's just like boom, that's that dun 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 dun. She could have done that, but I like that we're keeping it in the club and she went a different route. I do like that.
Sure. I do like that.
It's good, it keeps it cohesive.
I see what you mean.
bitch like culinary.
Jordan, that was disrespectful.
Wow, I didn't realize we went to the other song.
That was disrespectful. Thick is a fun one. Definitely a fun one. Reminds me of Beyonce, reminds me of, you know, something of that nature. Diva even, like, it's just something that is fun. But that I think it was very creative. For the club. Yeah. Definitely for the club.
Yeah.
Ass getting thick, bro.
Jordan, it's the one I've been waiting for. I've been waiting for America as a problem.
I will say this.
What's that?
I think All Up In Your Mind is in my top five.
I was about to actually say I really like All Up In Your Mind.
That might be my top five.
All Up In Your Mind.
Wow.
That's a very catchy hook.
She made it hard on me. Definitely that sexual energy is still there coming off Thick, even Heated. I like that.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Coming off of Heated.
That
yeah.
ending, the way that she mixed that was very, very interesting. I love that.
I was about to let it play, but America Has a Problem.
Yeah, I'm curious about that one.
But All Up In Your Mind, yeah, I'm going to be honest. At first, I was like, okay, let me catch a vibe. Mm-hmm. By the time we got to that second chorus, I was like, hell yeah.
Yeah.
I'm feeling this one. I like it.
America Has a Problem.
Oh, this is a tick up.
Make you wait a whole week for me. I see you watching, feeling. I know you want it, screaming. Know that booty gon' do what it want to. Can't hit it one time. Put the booty in the 40K at the trap. Get it with the rap, put it on the map. 20 minutes time with the grass. I be keen on the bag. Double G's on the dash. Nigga, I'm bad. Girl, you can't get no higher.
Wow, that's not at all. Oh shit!
That's a new song.
I didn't realize. Jordan, it's saying, it's, I don't like to say that word.
Check my technique. Coming from my technique. Bad bitches to the left. You can be full, meet in the middle, dance all night. Take it all off, or just a little. It should come. cost a billion to look this good. Bad bitch, Lisa, right then left cheek. Get your money, money, cutty, hunty.
Oh shit, pure honey. Oh, I like that.
Renaissance, study my technique.
Renaissance.
All the pretty boys to the floor. Don't my girls look so yummy? It should cost a billion to look this. I see you, woman, and you're coming for me. Devil's on my shoulder.
Oh!
Honey. Part two, honey.
If you give us a squeeze, what you give me, I don't, baby. I won't stop riding like a rodeo when I won't stop sucking my honey. Honey, 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 I put the sweet, sweet, sweet on your tummy. You know it's Friday night and I'm ready to drive. Throw me them keys, baby, let's go.
Damn, it's the last song.
Uh-oh, I'm scared.
I think Pure is a good song, yes. Right? But Honey takes the cake.
Oh yeah, the way that it built.
For that to be, what, all of 2 minutes?
The way that it was built.
That was incredible.
Entire time. I love the inserts, the samples.
Oh, that might be one of my favorites, yeah, just for the production.
Oh, I might say the same thing, top five again.
Damn!
This is a pretty long album. And she was able to keep my attention the entire time. Maybe in the move heated dick section.
Maybe it was like, okay.
I was like, okay, where are we going?
But then all up in your mind, America has a problem, pure honey. Yeah. And now Summer Renaissance.
Yes, yes.
Wow.
This album is really good.
This album is amazing.
Just another song, appreciating yourself.
Yes.
I know that a lot of the themes in this album are a lot of self-love as well.
Yes, I do notice
whether
that.
That's for your color, whether that's for being a woman, whether that's, you know, anything that makes you special.
Yeah.
You know, originality, personality, all of those things. They're being celebrated within this album. So this is another one of those bodies of work that kind of, it actually ended up being exactly what I predicted it to be off of Break My Soul, which is an album for the people.
That's yeah.
That's really what it feels like.
Yeah.
Like with a title like Renaissance.
I wanna house you. Make it take my name, I'm gonna spouse you, and make it touch a ring.
Oh,
I'm gonna
have
take you all the way, sexy motherfucker. Or you go right away, I just wanna touch
you. I fucking I knew it.
Wow.
I'm sorry. I fucking knew it.
Wow.
When I heard the beat, I was like,
wow.
I knew it. And the thing is, like, I didn't hear the sample at first.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh man, maybe I was wrong. Oh my God, I'm not.
Donna what Summer. What a way to go out, too.
Donna Summer.
The
oh
last
my
song
God.
Is the perfect sample and the perfect way to go
oh
out.
Oh my God. Oh my, this instantly became a favorite. It did. Don't lie.
Ooh.
It sounds like it continues with Act 2. Don't lie.
The way that it could.
The way that
or
it could.
Or the way that you could start the album over from that point.
No, literally.
Summer Renaissance. This song really just hits me as another song celebrating everything that's good.
Yeah.
Love, how you feel about yourself. life, ending the song saying, I'm in my bag, it's the summertime. It was definitely the perfect ender. And where this album is coming out within our summer, I think it's the perfect time. So
it truly is. I think that Donna Summer sample is so amazing. Again, I feel like Summer Renaissance, in a sense, does kind of sum up the album in a sense of... It's really an album just full of celebration. Really what it is. Again, she wanted a safe place, and she created it. This album, to me, this is an album for everybody.
I think so.
I think it's an album for everybody, even if you don't know it yet. Mm-hmm. It makes you feel... It honestly makes you forget for a moment. Right. And I think that was a point... Mm-hmm. that she wanted to make with the album, a feeling that she wanted to bring. It's just escaping for a minute and just being in the moment. And that's what this album does. All 16 tracks. Do you understand what I'm saying? Absolutely. And it's so versatile that I feel like, okay, someone may not like Thick, but someone's gonna like Virgo's Groove. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think that it takes you through such a journey to where you're gonna get up when you feel moved.
Yes.
And that's why I can see this being one of those albums that you just hit play on and let go all the way through. I love the title Renaissance for this because it perfectly describes a new moment in time.
Yes.
A new moment in Beyoncé's career. This is definitely the most unique album in terms of sound within her discography. I feel like this is an important time for her because Beyoncé's crossing that time in a career where it's like you either retire or you keep going. And she's chosen to keep going. And this is only act one out of an apparent three. So I am excited for this Renaissance era that I feel like is going to go on for a while. It's all about feeling
look
good.
At how she literally just reinvented herself.
Reinvented.
Another way to continue that longevity.
A new wave of music though. It is. Coming back.
And the thing is, again, which is, it's so hard to wrap my head around the fact that this is a Beyoncé album.
Yeah.
Because this is truly the most different sounding body of work in her discography. Nothing she has ever done. Not even on self-titled deluxe edition.
You can find elements,
gives me what Renaissance just gave me.
I know that it's for us to feel good. So that's pretty much what I'm walking away from this album with. Beyoncé, you've done it again. You've created a body of work that is going to speak to people. It's coming at the perfect time. It makes us want to get up. Like you said, it kind of makes us not forget, but escape for a moment.
Yeah, which I think escape
we
is
know
the right
was
word.
The goal. I'm tired as hell right now. It is 3:00 in the morning when we're filming this.
But it was worth it.
You feel invigorated at the same time.
You
and
really
you walk
do.
Away feeling positive. And the way that ended, you're right. It kind of sounds like it's leading into Act 2.
Into Act 2. As always, we'd love to know what you guys thought about this amazing new album. Let us know your top 5 down below in the comments.
If you enjoyed watching us react, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications, that way you know when we upload. And we'll catch you guys on the next one.